It's day 44 and the Songkran festival has arrived in Thailand, and boy is it wet. This is the biggest holiday celebration in the year in Thailand, and we were in Pattaya for it. We started out the day by getting out on the water to do a little bit of parasailing, and then took to the streets on the motorbikes a bit later on, and you can check out what happened.
In Thailand, and we're between charity visits, New Hope in Siem Reap, where we left a couple of days ago, and then a couple of days ahead in the expedition, we're meeting up with Ban Gerda in Lop Buri, just out of Thailand. So in between times, we're passing through Pattaya, and right now we're heading out to do some parasailing out in the ocean, and we're taking this old trawler out across the choppy seas. So see what adventure lies ahead.
Runway, Heathrow Airport. It's like a factory line out here. They just got this barge, which is stationary, and then a whole series of boat companies just come swinging by and pick you up off the front of the bow of this barge, and then drop you off here and do a loop around. It's a very good system. They're obviously making a lot of money. Thank you, filming. Okay, Ariel. No problem, you're a big girl.
Running.
Woo! Too easy. That is certainly like a production facility.
Yeah.
it really was amazing riding the motorbike with Alan along the beach road in Pattaya during Songkran. As you can see, we got completely and utterly hammered with water. As such, we weren't wearing our helmets or our full riding gear because we knew that anything we went out with was going to get completely and utterly drenched. It was so much fun. The local people are very, very into the celebration. The original origin of this festival is, you know, basically asking someone's permission, dousing them with a little tiny trickle of water to bless them and wish them good luck in the future. But over the years, it's given way to pump action water pistols and foreigners going absolutely crazy with these buckets of water that they douse on anyone that walks by. Being on a big bike, we were targets of a lot of attention throughout the afternoon and into the evening. After what had already been a huge day out parasailing and then riding around during the Songkran festival, Alan, Aria and I decided that we hadn't had enough, so we took to the go-kart track, which is the first time that Aria had actually been in a go-kart and driving herself, and I was so proud of the way she took to it. She was basically straight out in a cart that goes about 30 kilometers an hour, you know, racing around the track, showing no fear, but still being cautious and driving really, really well, apexing a corner here and there. Alan and I, meanwhile, the competitive spirit came out and we were racing along each other, had an absolute ball, so much so that we vowed to head back there the very next day.